Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A media flurry exploded several weeks ago when Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders of the Trump administration was thrown out of the Red Hen restaurant in Virginia because of her employment with the Trump administration. Conservatives and liberals divided even further, taking sides when the controversy erupted. Conservatives were livid, arguing that Huckabee Sanders was discriminated against for her political beliefs, while liberals argued that Huckabee Sanders got what was coming to her because of what the Trump administration has been doing with immigration issues at the border. But the Red Hen recently reopened, and what the owners and workers saw when they reopened will shock you. David Harris Jr. reported the far-left restaurant, the Red Hen, that forced Sarah Sanders to leave before finishing her meal, has reopened, complete with a security officer stationed outside in case any conservatives decide they are hungry. They were met by peaceful protesters angry that a baker can't refuse to bake a cake based on religious beliefs, but a restaurant can withhold food from a conservative based on ignorant political beliefs. The owner, Stephanie Wilkinson, not only asked Sanders to leave, but after she and her liberal-in-laws went to a restaurant across the street, Wilkinson organized a protest against them. Wilkinson is obviously built in the Maxine Waters model, but with fewer brain cells. Now that's a frightening thought. Sarah Sanders and her family were recently forced out of the Red Hen restaurant. The owner, Stephanie Wilkinson, followed Sanders' family across the street to another restaurant and formed a protest to continue the harassment. Congresswoman Maxine Waters threw kerosene onto the explosive controversy and told a cheering mob of Democrats to continue to harass and harm people in Trump's cabinet if they're spotted at restaurants or petrol stations. The message from the left is one of hate, violence, and tolerance and totalitarian rule. It is my most sincere wish that the Red Hen is forced to close its doors in the very near future. Trending, justice served. Maxine Waters busted, formal investigation underway now. CNN reported, outside the restaurant, several protesters held signs that said, "Hey Red Hen, go cluck yourself," and, "No civility, no peace, we're here today because actions have consequences." Paul Brockman, a spokesman for the Patriot Picket, a group that advocates for Second Amendment rights, told WDBJ, "We think the place for political statements is at the ballot box, not at the dinner table," he said. Others were there to support the restaurant. "I think it was very brave what the owner did, probably a very hard decision." Don Mandelkorn told WDBJ, "One sign read, Red Hen 2018 equals 1960 Woolworth lunch counter." New Jersey resident Terry Lehman told WDBJ he doesn't think the events are comparable, one centered around political ideology and the other around civil rights. Since Sanders' tweet, Red Hen has become emblematic of a national debate over civility and decency in a time of political differences. President Trump added to the incident's profile when he berated the restaurant in a tweet. "The Red Hen restaurant should focus more on cleaning its filthy canopies, doors and windows, badly needs a paint job, rather than refusing to serve a fine person like Sarah Huckabee Sanders. I always had a rule, if a restaurant is dirty on the outside, it is dirty on the inside," Trump said. Following Trump's tweet and an ensuing wave of protests, Stephanie Wilkinson, who co-owned Red Hen, resigned as the executive director of a local business group. Wilkinson told the Washington Post that she asked Sanders to leave at her staff's request and would have done the same thing again. Sanders isn't the only political figure to be confronted in public recently. Protesters accosted Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen in a Mexican restaurant in Washington just over 2 weeks ago. And this week, former EPA Administrator Scott Pruitt was confronted by a woman at a Washington restaurant who told him to resign before your scandals push you out. According to WDBJ, it is currently unclear when Red Hen will be accepting walk-in customers. The restaurant did not respond to CNN's request for comment. The Red Hen has been closed down for so long because what they did was wrong, and they have been receiving backlash as a result. Their social media pages were flooded and they lost an extraordinary amount of business. Apparently, it is wrong to discriminate against people who are liberal or tout liberal views, but when it is done to a conservative, then it is perfectly fine. You cannot have it both ways. Either you are opposed to discrimination entirely or you are not. Any other stance is hypocritical. While one can hope and pray the owner and workers at the Red Hen have learned the lesson, they in all likelihood have not. Nothing will teach them a lesson because liberals and Democrats believe they have the morally self-righteous ground. when in reality they do not. This type of behavior and discrimination will continue to happen if they do not do anything about it. Argument heating up outside the Red Hen. pic.twitter.com/memoolkaniniab Caroline Simon, at Caroline Simon 66, July 5, 2018. Butch Barley, of Concord, VA. pic.twitter.com/9canbajvo Caroline Simon, at Caroline Simon 66, July 5, 2018. The first protesters from the Patriot Picket have started to arrive. pic.twitter.com/5of2102ha Caroline Simon, at Caroline Simon 66, July 5, 2018. One Facebook planned protest scheduled to start between 3 and 4 is called Cluck You, Caroline Simon, at Caroline Simon 66, July 5, 2018. Conservative protesters arrive for reopening of Red Hen. pic.twitter.com/ofubga7 Jack Posobiec, United States, at Jack Posobiec, July 5, 2018. Share if you agree these protesters did the right thing. Share if you believe that Sarah Huckabee Sanders should not have been treated that way. Share if you think that freedom of thought, employment, and speech is still protected under the Constitution. Share if that means something to you.